up, look into this week's sports with all their updates with Leslie Fox.
And it sounds like Tiger Woods is in the tabloids a lot. Can you tell us about what
He just keeps digging himself further in the hole. I tell you, even though Tiger Woods continues to avoid facing the public, he did announce today on his personal website that he plans to take an indefinite break from golf. The world's number one golfer gave no indication as to when he plans to return to the sport. Woods said Friday this leave is for him to concentrate on saving his marriage and prepare the damages caused to his family after a Thanksgiving Day car crash and weeks of allegations involving extramarital affairs. Well, Chauncey Billups' homecoming in Detroit was spoiled by the Pistons as they beat the Nuggets in a nail-biter Thursday night. This loss makes it just the second time the Nuggets have lost back-to-back games this season. The rebuilding and banged-up Pistons capitalized on plenty of Denver's mistakes, including 15 turnovers. You know, Billups had a chance to win it or to tie it with 6 seconds to go, but he failed to make the layup, and the Pistons win it with a final score of 101-98.
I never let this, I always just remember my years here, you know what I'm saying, and how this building was so crazy, so I'm never going to let this put a blemish on what I feel about this building and the fans here.
The Denver Broncos are back on track after two straight wins, but they're still heavy underdogs as they prepare to take on the perfect 12-0 Colts Sunday in Indy. The Broncos defense will have their work cut out for them as they try to stop Peyton Manning from leading his team to a spot in the record books with 22 consecutive wins in the regular season. If the Colts can continue perfection and improve to 13-0, they'll lock up home field advantage throughout the AFC playoffs.
Obviously, all we can control is trying to beat Denver, you know, and that's one thing we haven't really done much this year. Coach Caldwell does not really, you know, give us the updates of what's going on around the league. You know, all he kind of tells us is reminds us of who we're playing, what they do on defense, offense, and special teams, and what he thinks we need to do to win.
Well, things just keep getting worse for the defending Super Bowl champs. Big Ben was sacked 8 times in an embarrassing loss to the Cleveland Browns Thursday. The Browns get just their second win of the season as they beat the Steelers 13-6. Well, unlike the Steelers, the Heritage Eagles have a lot to celebrate after winning the 4A Colorado State Championships last Saturday. Today, Heritage High School held a rally to commemorate the Eagles' memorable win. The championship plaque was unveiled in the school gym that marks the 42-28 defeat over Longmont.
A lot of things going on in sports. I hope those Nuggets win the game tonight.
Yep, they play the Phoenix Suns, so see what they can show.
Yeah.
Well, that's all the news that we have for tonight. Thank you for tuning in.
The Colorado Sun overlooks many breathtaking scenes in Denver, but the Red Rocks Amphitheater is among the most spectacular. Millions of people have visited this historical site to enjoy an open-air concert, but music isn't the only thing you'll hear from each of its 9,000 seats. For some NFL players who are looking to push themselves to the limit, they turn to personal trainer Lauren Lando with an incredibly difficult exercise.
The distance between, it's at least a yard of hip projection these athletes have to generate. So they've got to generate that much force to get their hips to the next successive stair. Not only are you dealing with the distance, but you also have a slight elevation component.
The steep incline the venue has to offer prepares guys specifically for game time.
We run these ladders, run these steps here, the first 10 yards, work that fast twitch muscle fiber, and then 20 and the 30. And progressively, when you run away to the top, that stimulates the fourth quarter. Two minutes, 3 minutes left, just trying to make it through, and that's what the last run all the way to the top emphasizes.
Although these sprints are rigorous, there's a nice reward waiting at the top.
This is the way you end it right here. Get to look over the city. See where you're at, see where you come from.
You don't have to be a professional athlete to work out at Red Rocks. All 437 steps are open to the public. Leslie Fox, 9 News.